Hello friends, welcome.
Today I'm doing a simple little draw with me video, but with my all-time favorite watercolor paints, which we'll get into that a bit later. I'm starting off with my sketch. I went for a very simple, straightforward drawing of a girl. I'm going in and just lightly sketching the guidelines of where the facial features will be. I was really excited to get drawing with my pencil because one of my last pencil sketches of a girl came out really nice. I really love how the style came out, and so I was kind of trying to study that and see what about that illustration that I made that I really loved. I then went ahead and took a picture of my sketch and flipped the canvas horizontally just so that I can see all the mistakes and whatever I drew asymmetrically so I can go in with the touch-ups. Some quick anatomy tips for you guys: when you're drawing, the space in between your eyes should be the size of one eye. So basically, you should be able to fit one eye in between the two eyes. I don't know if that made any sense. Next, the edges of the nose should roughly line up with the inner corners of the eyes, and the corners of the lips should line up to where the middle of the eye is. Hopefully that helps, but those are just some go-tos that I always think about when I'm drawing the guidelines of a face.
Well, good painting.
So now that I have all my colors mixed up, I'm going in with a more diluted version of my skin tones for the highlights. In the last clip of my paint, I forgot to shake up the tubes of the paint, but usually the consistency of these watercolors is actually like a very thick acrylic paint that you can just add as much water to as you please, which is a really fun process for me. So after I go in and paint the rest of the face in one mid-tone throughout, and then I add the darkest version of that color for the shadows, along with a muted kind of pinkish reddish color for a ton of blush, and that was basically it for the face, along with a ton of blending with water. So the reason why I went for such a simple girl with such a plain, boring expression honestly was because watercolors aren't my usual specialty, so I didn't want to try too many things. I just wanted to stick with the easy thing, which honestly I feel like I make that excuse way too much. As much as art is supposed to be something that brings you joy and you shouldn't push yourself too hard, you don't want to forget to step out of your comfort zone sometimes, because that's really the only way you'll improve, is if you try new things, even if that means that your art may look really bad during that learning process. I know y'all hate me for this one, but trust me, I'm speaking to myself too, because I draw the same thing way too much, and I'm trying to work on it. So that's all you can really do. Which is kind of exactly what happened with this watercolor drawing. I kind of hate it, but also kind of love it. It's a really weird relationship that I have with the final piece, so I guess you're gonna have to keep on watching so you can decide what you think about it. So I got all my inspiration from Pinterest as per usual, as I was looking at all these really beautifully painted watercolor illustrations, and I often found myself more gravitated to the more messy, splotchy kind of style, often known as a painterly look, which is not something thing I've really ever tried to achieve, but I slowly started to fixate on little things a little too much, and I had to go in and fix this and that, and I was trying to blend paint that wasn't made for the paper I was using. I knew I loved these watercolors because I've done drawings with them on watercolor paper before. No wonder why watercolor paint worked better on watercolor paper. I didn't even think about how the watercolors would work in my ELO sketchbook. I failed to recognize the importance of using a very textured paper, aka the complete opposite of my ELO. So you live and you learn. Now I'm gonna give you guys a second to appreciate the beautiful ASMR I have for you. So overall, the drawing wasn't exactly what I had in mind because of my paper texture, but I think I still do kind of like the end result. It's very different from my usual art, which is refreshing for a bit of a change-up sometimes. And there we have it, my friends. I'm finished with my watercolor illustration. I hope you guys enjoyed this kind of chatty draw with me kind of video. It didn't really have like any purpose. I just kind of talked, but I had a ton of fun. So I hope you guys enjoy it. I hope maybe you guys learned a thing or two from my mistakes. Thank you all so much for watching, and I hope to see you next time for another one. Bye.